For being one of the closest objects to us celestially, we still know about as much about the planet Mars as we do about the depths of the ocean. Which is to say, well, not a lot. The things we've seen in pop culture about Mars make us conjure a red, dusty planet where Matt Damon grows poo potatoes. But there's a lot more to Mars than just that. Mars is the second smallest planet in the solar system, with only around 10% of the Earth's mass. Yet Earth and Mars have about the same amount of actual land. Mars also has the tallest mountain in the entire known solar system. Mars's largest moon, Phobos, will be torn from the planet's orbit one day, creating a ring that will last hundreds of millions of years. Those are some really cool things that we know about the planet, but there are still many Martian mysteries that we haven't quite figured out yet. Number 10. Mars has two drastically different hemispheres. The northern and southern hemispheres of Earth may have different kinds of topography, but they're relatively similar. Mars, on the other hand, has a much lower and flatter northern hemisphere, while the southern hemisphere has an average elevation that's about 3 miles higher. That's a pretty drastic difference geologically speaking, and no other planet we know of exhibits such a trait. Scientists once thought that a huge asteroid could have crashed into the top half of Mars early in its life, making a much flatter northern hemisphere. Later computer simulations rendered that theory less than ideal unless the asteroid only glanced against the planet. Newer theories suggest that the resulting magma flow from such a cosmic punch would have inundated the southern hemisphere, creating the resulting terrain elevation difference. Number 9. Mars has a lot of methane, which is usually produced by living things. We humans normally have a slight knowledge of methane from jokes about cow farts, and methane is a part of that. Methane is a greenhouse gas that contributes to the rising warmth of the Earth. It's trapped in our atmosphere and causes the temperature of our planet to rise even more than carbon dioxide does. Mars, curiously, has a lot of methane too, but here's the kicker. Methane is usually released by living things, at least for the most part. So why is it that a planet we've never discovered life on has this sort of biosignature? Well, we don't know yet. It could have been trapped under ice for ages, or caused by a release from ancient microbes on the planet, or even from a freak chemical reaction. We do know that a plume of methane was detected by spacecraft in Mars's orbit more than once, which is notable because the gas is finicky to pick up, especially in such a thin atmosphere that the planet possesses. Number 8. Mars has signs of water, but it can't be from the surface. The discovery of ice near the poles of Mars sent ripples throughout the scientific community in 2008. If there's ice, that means there's water, and if there's water, that means there could be life. Right? Well, just slow down a second, because, well, there's a lot more going on here. Yes, there have been more and more spottings of icy polar caps and frost-filled craters, and that's really cool, but what if we told you there was a subterranean lake of standing water on Mars? It shouldn't be possible. Liquids at that depth from the surface should have a temperature of minus 68 degrees Celsius. Orbiting satellites have yet to get a visual on this lake, but that could be hard since, you know, it's underground. And of course, a portion of the scientific community is using this to prove that life on Mars is an undisputable truth. It is pretty tempting, especially if you think back to how we humans began. Number 7. Can we live on Mars? This one seems pretty straightforward. It would seem to be a hard no, right? The atmosphere on Mars is completely different, and we definitely couldn't walk around outside. Yet, in direct defiance of all things wholly insane, NASA is determined to get the ball rolling on human colonization of Mars. By 2030, they think they'll have feet on the red planet. Radiation is an obvious concern if we were ever to set up shop there, so underground shelters would be a requisite. We can't grow food in the soil at all, but humans have to start from scratch here on Earth as well, so we'd likely find a way to use Mars's alien resources to develop new methods of survival. There really isn't a way to know how we could fare on Mars long term until the first people reach the planet. Number 6. Why did Mars totally change its climate? 1 billion years in the grand scheme of the universe isn't much at all. 4 billion years ago, judging from the vast veins of old waterbeds on Mars's surface, water flowed all over the planet. Since we know that Mars is about 4.5 billion years old, science can say with some certainty that the red, dusty planet we think of now actually used to be quite moist. Then, somewhere along the way, in the next few billion years, something happened. The atmosphere of Mars started disappearing. Then, the Sun reached the next stage in its life cycle of a star and it became hotter. So how did the red planet continue to have water in a place in the universe where the Sun should have evaporated at all? Scientists have a pretty cool sounding theory that maybe Mars was in an orbit much closer to the Sun, closer to Venus, and then began trailing behind like a sea student, eventually ending up where it presently resides. It's also about the best answer we currently have, because we don't even really know why Earth has water. Number 5. We don't know much about Mars's two moons. For being as close as it is to Earth, we really know very little about Mars, and even less about its two weird moons. These are called Phobos and Deimos. Some think they may have possibly been asteroids that were snagged into orbit by Mars, but the problem is that with that theory, the shapes and angles of the moons don't necessarily fit. More likely, something struck Mars hard and flung the eventual moons out into orbit. And while we're on the realm of the weird, there are some formations on Phobos that would give conspiracy theorists night sweats. There's what seems to be a large rectangular monolith on Phobos standing over 90 meters tall. While it's likely just an abnormal chunk of Martian rock, it's still pretty notable. Number 4. What caused the bright white light in a 2019 photo? When you're in charge of receiving photos of Mars from a rover a great distance away, you might be taken aback when you see a picture with a bright white spot where there shouldn't be. An image taken in June of 2019 by the Curiosity rover showed a weird white glow emanating in the distance behind some hills. Aliens were the immediate explanation by non-scientists, as you might expect. But it was most likely a lens flare or a cosmic ray, and NASA admittedly had captured tons of these things. The white anomaly doesn't show up in pictures taken immediately before or after the event, and the team that created the Curiosity's camera system says that they come across oddities of pictures with bright spots every week. Number 3. What lines the dry ice pits at Mars's poles? We mentioned before that the poles of Mars contain some known deposits of ice, which means liquid, which means potential for life. We know that near the southern pole there is a subglacial lake, the first known stable body of water that we found on the planet. What's really interesting about those polar caps is that nearby there are some pits of dry ice that are lined with, well, we don't really know what they're lined with. These pits are huge, some of them are 200 feet across. There is the possibility that the dust there could be lined with gold, but we still don't know for sure. Number 2. How do Mars's giant storms happen? The thin, brittle atmosphere on Mars is absolutely perfect for some truly epic dust storms that can shoot particles at speeds of over 60 miles per hour, and in some cases cover the entire planet for weeks at a time. The thing is, these planetary-scale dust storms still hold a lot of mysteries in them. We think they may be the largest dust storms in the solar system, and since the planet is essentially a desert, it doesn't take much to get them rolling. And while science is pretty sure that sunshine is the catalyst, they aren't too sure how they got to become so massive. One theory thinks that the dust particles are warmed by the sunlight, which then warm the thin atmosphere, causing more wind and thus capturing more particles in a repeating cycle. Or it could be aliens. Who really knows? Number 1. Did Earth life come from Mars? Bear with us here, because we're about to get a bit weird. So perhaps you're already passingly familiar with the basic theories of how life began – Big Bang, primordial ooze, etc. Well, early on in Earth's history, the building blocks of life were pretty much non-existent. Remember how we mentioned that early Mars could have been a quintessential Goldilocks planet? Well, what if the essentials for life came from outer space, survived the trip on a meteorite, for example, and then arrived on Earth and evolved from there? It's something science is seriously considering. It's called panspermia, and it's suggests that life arrived on our home planet in the form of spores. So basically, life may have arrived on Earth and not started on it. The primordial soup version of life building holds some water, sure, but it's that exact water that almost kills RNA, a fundamental part of genetics, in its tracks. Minerals like boron give life to RNA, and those were plentiful on Mars 4 billion years ago. So when we talk about aliens on Mars, we might just be referring to our last universal common ancestor. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, smash that like button below. And do not forget to subscribe. I've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. And why not check out another channel I do called Geographics? We actually did a video all about Mars. You can find it linked to below. And as always, thank you for watching.